أصبح وأنا لا أريد الصوم. Sometimes I used to wake up in the morning and I don't want any, or I don't want to be fasting on that day, and then I would fast. واضح؟ Okay. So as long as the person doesn't eat or drink, واضح؟ And he doesn't do some of the things that is going to invalidate his fast, then he can fast on that day. And this is for a voluntary type of fasting. Okay? This is for a voluntary type of fasting. طيب بنية يفرض في رمضان. What does Ramadan mean? Have you ever guys like thought about what does Ramadan or where does the word come from? He said burning. جميل. Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned this in his tafsir. Ramadan was only called Ramadan لأنه يرمض الذنوب. Because it burns. أي يحرق الأعمال السيئة بالأعمال الصالحة. It burns the evil deeds that a person has been committing throughout the year with the righteous action that he does in the month of Ramadan. Okay? This is why the Messenger of Allah, when you look at the word Salatul Awwabin, حِينَ تَرْمِضُ الْفِصَالِ Salatul Awwabin is Salatul Duha. The best time to pray Salatul Duha is when it gets the hottest. Huh? In places like Saudi Arabia, if you try to walk outside, this happened to me one time. And I started running from one side of the courtyard all the way to the other because they were giving out books and I thought, oh, let me just go outside inshallah ta'ala without any shoes. My shoes were on the other side of the haram. I got into the courtyard and wallah, I started running. I could not bear it. And we're looking for a guy. We get told he's here. We run there. Then somebody said, no, he's there. So I run onto the other side of the, huh? The other side of the courtyard and I couldn't bear it. There's times when it gets the hottest. And that is what? Before Dhuhr. There's a period before Dhuhr when it gets the hottest. When the sun is out as, you know, as west. And that's the best time to pray the Dhuha. So in this hadith, Salatul Awwabin Hina Tarmidul Fasal. The Salat of the Awwabin. Those who constantly repent back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. The Salat they pray of Dhuha is when it gets the hottest. The word Tarmud was used, which comes with the root letters as well. Ramadan, right? So here, Tarmud was said, was mentioned. And the month of Ramadan, Shahru Ramadan, comes from the same root letters. Okay? So this is exactly where the word comes from. بنية يفرض في رمضان برؤية أو انقضاء شعبان. So the next issue that the poet he discusses is how the month of Ramadan is established. Okay? We know that the month of Ramadan has kicked in through three ways. Two, in which the scholars have unanimously agreed on. The third one, they differed. What is the first way? The first way is if the moon is sighted and seen. طيب. And that's something that, you know, is very well known. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمْ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْ Whoever witnesses the month, meaning has seen the crescent, then let him fast. Then let him fast. And the Messenger of Allah عليه وسلم, he also said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوا فَصُومُوا وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوا فَأَفْطِرُوا When you see the moon, then fast. Meaning at the beginning of the month of Ramadan, the end of Sha'ban. And وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوا فَأَفْطِرُوا And also if you see at the end of Ramadan, then break your fast. Meaning celebrate the Eid al-Fitr. واضح? So we know that if it is seen with the eye, then the month of Ramadan has kicked in. And that's something that has been unanimously agreed on. Okay? The second way to know if the month of Ramadan has kicked in is, and this is also something that has been agreed on, once 30 days comes to an end, the month of Sha'ban. 30 days of the month of Sha'ban has finished, then the month of Ramadan has started. This is when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ash-shahru hakadha, Ash-shahru hakadha. And then he pointed with his fingers, making the sign of 30. واضح? So these are two ways that we know that the month of Ramadan has kicked in. But the third one, they differed. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala was by himself on this issue. And the majority of the scholars of the Ahnaf, Imam Abu Hanif rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam al-Shafi, and also Imam Malik, they took a different position. But inshallah ta'ala, when you guys write this down, maybe have a part of your page where you write the madhab Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, and then all the other issues that I mentioned, you may be mentioning it, you may write it on another part. So you guys know the position of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, because we're trying to build ourselves on this madhab, right? And then later on, inshallah ta'ala, one can inshallah choose to strengthen one opinion over the other. But that's obviously when we study more and more, inshallah ta'ala. So, we've established two ways. And these two ways have been unanimously agreed on. Then the Mu'allif rahimahullah ta'ala, he goes on to say, وَكَانَ غَيْمٌ مَانِعٌ لِلرَّائِ وَحُوهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ التَّرَائِ. طيب, let me try to explain and break that down, inshallah ta'ala. The Muslims, they go out on the 29th day. We always have that day, right? Where everybody is like wondering, is it going to be Ramadan tomorrow? Is it not going to be Ramadan tomorrow? Huh? And we're all wishing that it is. Because we're so looking forward to the month of Ramadan, right? So the Muslims, they go out in order to sight the moon. Okay? But sometimes you find that your vision is blurred. It may be because there is clouds covering the crescent. Or maybe because there is dust particles. It is dusty and you can't see the crescent. Or maybe because there is what? Huh? Smoke covering the crescent. Are you with me, guys? We're not talking about when the sky is clear. That has been unanimously agreed on. We're speaking about now, Muslims, they go out in order to sight the moon. But something is covering their vision of the moon. In that case, the scholars have differed. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, it is wajib upon that individual to fast. The Muslims have to fast on that day. Are you with me, guys? This might come as a shock to some of us. This was the madhab Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala. Where did this whole discussion root off from? Where did it come from? It came from a wording that was mentioned in the hadith. When the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوا فَصُومُوا وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوا فَأَفْتِرُوا فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ. If your vision is now blurred because of maybe what? Clouds, or there being dust, or there be maybe being smoke, whatever it might be. The most important thing is that your vision has now been blurred. You can't see the crescent because of your vision being blurred. The madhab states, and that's the official position, okay, that you have to fast the next day. Because here the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ. And this is where they differed. The interpretation that the scholars, they took out from this particular wording was different. Because when you look at the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla, there's a verse where Allah Azza wa Jalla says, اللَّهُ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ يَقْدِرُ فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ. There's a similarity, right? It has the same root letters. In the ayah, Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, اللَّهُ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. There is people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a lot of provision to. And some people, He doesn't give much to. He tightens it on them. So they took that meaning. They said, فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ means to tighten that day. Or to tighten the situation. Meaning, we're going to fast the next day. But the majority of the scholars, the Jumhur, they say no. We have another hadith that explains this hadith. What does the other hadith state? فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَأَكْمِلُوا عِدَّةَ شَعْبَانَ ثَلَاثِينَ. If your vision is blurred, then complete 30 days in the month of Sha'ban. And this is a strong view on this issue. Because we have the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that explains the other statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We also have something that Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned. He said, مَنْ صَامَ الْيَوْمَ الَّذِي يُشَكُّ فِيهِ فَقَدْ عَصَى بِالْقَاسِمِ ذكر البخاري تعليقا ووصل الخمسة. عمار بن ياسر رضي الله تعالى عنه said, whoever fasts the day that is doubted, the day of shak, which is basically this day that I'm speaking about, right? فقد عصى أبا القاسم. This individual now, he has disobeyed أبا القاسم. Who's أبا القاسم? مثل صلى الله عليه وسلم, that was his kunya. Now my kunya is Abu Taymi, right? But my real name is Muhammad. Kunya of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was أبا القاسم. Or Abu al-Qasim, depending on the i'rab of the sentence. طيب, did the Hanabila, those who follow the madhab Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, just look at this narration of Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu ta'ala and just throw it behind their backs? No, they said, okay, they completely gave it a different interpretation. They said if the Muslim comes out and there is nothing covering his vision, okay, and then he fasts, and this is when this hadith applies to him, of him having disobeyed Abu Qasim. You with me, guys? But anyways, we don't want to confuse you guys. Point of the matter is that Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala holds the view that if the Muslim comes out and they try to sight the moon, huh, and the vision is blurred, then he has to fast. But the majority of the scholars, they say otherwise. So write down Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala and concentrate on that for the time being, because we're trying to build our foundation on the method of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala. But also bear in mind that the other scholars mentioned that. Okay? Tayyib. Is everybody's witness accepted? The one who sights the moon and goes to the hakim or goes to the judge or goes to the king of his country and tells him that I have now seen the moon. He has to have certain characteristics. He has to be a trustworthy, upright individual in his religion. Wadih? And this is exactly what was the case with regards to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when some of the companions came up to him. And how many people do we need before we say that the month of Ramadan, or we announce to the people that the month of Ramadan has been established? 1, 2, 3. Who can tell me?
Just one righteous person.
One righteous, upright individual is also trustworthy. And this has been taken from the hadith ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, "Tara al-nasu al-hilala." The Muslims, they went out in order to sight the moon. فَرَأَيْتُهُ فَأَخْبَرْتُ النَّبِيِّ صلى الله عليه وسلم أَنِّي رَأَيْتُهُ. So I ended up seeing it. I went to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and I told him that I seen the crescent. What did the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do? Did he tell him, no, I need another person? He said that no. فَصَامَ وَأَمَرَ النَّاسَ بِالصِّيَامِهِ. He fasted and he commanded everybody else to go and fast as well. This was narrated by the Khamsa. The four books of hadith are who? When I say Al-Khamsa, to who do I mean? I remember I asked you these guys last year and you all got it wrong. No Nabi. Nasa'i, Tirmidhi, Abu Dawud, huh? No, Ibn Majah. Where did Bayhaqi come from? They are the four books, the Sunan. When we hear the Kutub al-Sitta, it means Bukhari and Muslim. Huh? And then the other four books, Al-Nasa'i, Ibn Majah, Abu Dawud, and also At-Tirmidhi. But Ibn Hajar, a lot of these hadith that I quote, you can find in Bulugh al-Maram. And Ibn Hajar, Al-Asqalani rahimahullah ta'ala, sometimes he says, Akhrajuhu al-Khamsa, narrated by the five, narrated by the four. When he says narrated by the five, so we know that for who's the fifth one? Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala. But if he says narrated by the seven, it means Imam Ahmad the four and also Bukhari Muslim. So here now, this hadith was narrated by the five, Akhraju al-Khamsa. So that's one hadith. Also, you have the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Anna a'rabiyan jail al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A Bedouin came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said to him, Inni ra'aytu al-hilal. I have seen the crescent. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tried to check out his what? His integrity. He said, Atashhadu an la ilaha illallah? Do you bear witness that nobody has the right to be worshipped except Allah? He said, yes. أَتَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ He said, yes. Do you also bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the final messenger? He said, yes. What did the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم do? He said, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, قُبْ يَا بِلَالُ فَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ يَا بِلَالُ أَنْ يَصُومُ غَدًا. He told Bilal رضي الله تعالى عنه to go and announce to the people to fast tomorrow. And there was only one person that came to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. واضح؟ Also Allah Azza wa Jalla, he did say this, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرِ. Whoever from amongst you, okay, witnesses the moon, then fast on that day.
بِرُؤْيَةٍ وَمِنْقِضَى شَعْبَانَ وَكَانَ غَيْمٌ مَانِعٌ لِلرَّائِي وَنَحْوُهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ التَّرَائِي وَيَلْزَمُ الصِّيَامُ كُلَّ قَادِرِي مِنْ مُسْلِمٍ مُكَلَّفٍ وَحَاضِرِي.
So if you look at the end of the technical meaning of a psalm, okay, carries, is min shakhsin makhsus. So we mention what? Huwa imsakun an shayin makhsus. It is to withhold from something specifically. Okay? Then what did he say? Fi waqtin makhsus. And also the imsak, one has to withhold at a specific time. Nobody said to you to go and fast the whole day, the full 24 hours. And what did I say? بِنِيَّةٍ مَخْصُوصَةٍ With a specific intention, right? And the fourth thing is what? When you look at the definition of a psalm, in its technical sense, huh? مِنْ شَخْصٍ مَخْصُوصٍ From a specific person. Because the fasting, my brothers and my sisters, is not mandatory upon everybody. And this is what he mentions in the last line of poetry in this chapter. It says, وَيَلْزَمُ الصِّيَامُ كُلَّ قَادِرٍ مِنْ مُسْلِمٍ مُكَلَّفٍ وَحَاضِرٍ Every person who has the ability. Who is the one who has the ability? The one who's sick and the one who is traveling. Okay? This no longer applies to them. Even though they might be, or they might have the ability to fast, but is it wajib upon them? The answer is no. Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ Whoever is sick or is traveling, okay? It is not the case as to why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the permission for a person who's traveling not to fast, okay? Because sometimes he might have the ability. It is not the only reason why Allah Azza wa Jal gave him the permission not to fast. But it's from the reasons why, you know, when you look at the hikmah and so on and so forth. Okay? Because sometimes people travel, but they don't have any mashaqqah. They don't have many mashaqqah, meaning any difficulty. But the majority of the people, they do tend to find difficult, okay? Find it difficult to fast while traveling. But all of this, inshallah ta'ala, maybe we'll discuss it another time. Point of the matter is, the qadir, he has to have the ability. So the individual now has become very, very old in age. Okay? Has become very, very old in age. Like Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he became very, very old in age, he never used to fast. He used to do fidya, which we'll come into inshallah ta'ala mention another or later on. And likewise, a woman who might fear for herself because of her pregnancy. Okay? And also maybe her breastfeeding. Okay, inshallah we will elaborate on that later on as well. So Al-Qadir, somebody who has the ability to fast. If the person doesn't have the ability, is the fasting wajib on that individual? The answer is no. وَيَلْزَمُ الصِّيَامُ كُلَّ قَادِرِ مِنْ مُسْلِمٍ Also that person has to be a Muslim. If a kafir, a disbeliever, a non-Muslim, wanted to fast, is his fasting going to be accepted from him? And also, is it wajib upon him? The answer is no. Even if he was to fast, he will come on Yawm al-Qiyamah, all his good deeds will be like scattered particles. He wouldn't get anything from it. As Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا He will come on Yawm al-Qiyamah with a lot of good deeds that he used to do. Maybe he was nice to the people. Okay? Maybe he did fast for a couple of months because he wanted to try. But he never embraced Islam. Okay? And it's going to be like scattered particles. And all the other good things that he done. A issue that is normally studied in Usul al-Fiqh is هل الكفار مخاطبون بفروع الشريعة? Are the kuffar, are they being addressed when we find all of these ayat in the Quran? وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ Establish the prayer. وَأَتَوُ الزَّكَاةِ You know, also give zakah. Are they being addressed as well? The correct view is that they are being addressed. They are being addressed. But at the same time, it is not wajib upon them to come with these ibadat. But on Yawm al-Qiyamah, he's going to be punished for it. So on Yawm al-Qiyamah, he's going to be punished for his disbelief. And also because he didn't pray when the time of the salah kicked in. Or let's just say, for example, this individual, he had money in his bank. And he had reached the nisab and a whole year had gone past. If he didn't pay that zakat, he's going to be punished for that as well. And if he was to pray, it wouldn't be accepted from him. Wadih, guys? Every Ramadan that comes is going to be what? Punished for it. Firstly, because he didn't embrace the Islam, and also because that Ramadan went past and he didn't fast it. But anyways, this is an issue that is studied in Usul al-Fiqh. One of my favorite subjects. And I talked to you guys about this last week as well. Usul al-Fiqh. You know what one of the scholars mentioned? Al-Usulu. Surah al-Nusus min al-Lusus. I'll repeat again. Al-Usul, Surah al-Nusus min al-Lusus. Al-Usul, meaning Usul al-Fiqh. It's like a gate. OK? Okay, it's like a gate around the nusus, which basically means what? The textual evidence from the Quran, the Sunnah. We call it nusus, or nas, nusus. Min al nusus. I know these words, they rhyme with one another. What does nusus mean? It means thieves. Meaning those who try to steal from the Sharia. How do you steal from the Sharia? Huh? By bringing into it things and taking things out. Wadih? I thought I'd mention that. Even though it wasn't part of the lesson. In Muslimin mukallafin wa hadiri. And then he goes on to say mukallaf, somebody who is religiously obliged. Somebody who is religiously obliged. That means he can't be somebody who hasn't reached the age of puberty. Okay, somebody who's not baligh. And also somebody who doesn't have sanity. So two characteristics need to be found. Somebody needs to reach the age of puberty. And he also has to what? Be sane. Because the person who is not sane, the siyam, the fasting is not wajib on that individual. Wadih? So let's talk a bit about bulugh, reaching the age of puberty. Recently I had a brother who messaged me and he said, brother, okay, I'm 14 years old and I haven't had a wet dream yet. Okay, and is the month of Ramadan wajib on me? I asked him a question. Do you have any hairs growing on your pubic area? He said, yes. The other question that I asked him was, did you have a wet dream? In fact, he didn't tell me that he had a wet dream. He just told me I'm at the age of 14, I haven't reached 15 years old yet. So he understood that one of the signs to know, if one has reached the age of puberty, he has to be what? He has to be 15 years old. There are three alamat. It's not just one. Okay, I'll rephrase that. There are three alamat. There are three signs, okay, that cause us now to know that one has reached the age of puberty. And you only need one from the three in order for the fasting to become wajib on that individual. And the salah and the rest of the ibadat. Okay, so this individual, he did not reach the age of 15. Haya? So I asked him the question. Okay, do you have any pubic hairs? And obviously sometimes when I know it's a bit cringe and asking a little kid like, do you have that? But I have to ask that question, right? I'm the one that's being asked the question because he needs the answer. And it's actually really, really good.